What is an earthquake and how does it occur? We often see and hear news about earthquakes. Perhaps you must have even felt an earthquake. Earthquakes are a natural phenomenon which occurs frequently on the Earth. There are also some man-made causes of earthquakes, but they are much weaker than natural earthquakes. When an earthquake occurs, we feel the shaking or vibration of the Earth, which creates a panic situation for everyone. This question must have come to your mind about how this earthquake occurs and what are the causes of earthquakes. It's okay if you don't know the answers to these questions. Because in today's video, we will give you all the information related to the earthquake. In today's video, you will know the answers to all the questions like what is an earthquake, why earthquakes occur and how many types are there. So let's go ahead without any delay and know the complete information. When the Earth's surface starts shaking or vibration is produced, it is called an earthquake. Earthquakes are caused by the internal energy coming out of the Earth, which produces seismic waves. Earthquakes are measured on the basis of their intensity. Some earthquakes are very weak, which we cannot feel. While some earthquakes are very powerful, which can push objects and human beings in the air and can bring destruction to the cities and villages. Earthquakes can move and displace land on the Earth's surface or destroy land. When the epicenter of a major earthquake is in the ocean away from the coast, they can cause a tsunami. Earthquakes, landslides, and sometimes can also give rise to volcanic activities. After knowing what an earthquake is, now it is time to know why and how an earthquake occurs. So let's know about the reason behind the earthquake. Before knowing the reason for the earthquake, we have to understand the structure of the Earth. Our Earth is made up of tectonic plates, in which the number of main plates is 7. All these plates are layers of weak and soft rocks present under the Earth's lithosphere, which are in liquid state to some extent. Floats on. That is, instead of being stable, the plates keep on moving at a slow pace. Usually the relative motion of the plates is 0 to 10 centimeters. Happens annually, which is a very slow pace. Earthquake means sudden movement of the Earth's crust. Generally, most earthquakes occur where tectonic plates meet. The crack between them is called the fault line. Earthquakes are generated when plates collide, spread or slide under each other. As the plates come together, they stick together due to friction and pressure builds up on them. When this pressure increases excessively and crosses a critical value, the force of friction becomes weak. Due to the weakening of friction, there is a sudden movement between the sticking plates, due to which the fault is formed. When a fault is formed, there is a violent displacement of the Earth's surface and strain energy, deformation energy, is generated. Seismic waves are generated due to energy due to which we feel earthquake tremors or vibrations. Whether the earthquake was mild or strong depends on the pressure. When the frictional force between two sticking plates weakens due to excessive pressure, excessive movement occurs and fault is formed. Due to this fault, there is displacement in the upper surface of the Earth and the release of energy causes seismic waves are generated. Let us now know what are the types of these faults. There are three types of faults caused by interplate earthquakes between two tectonic plates. Normal fault. Reverse fault. Strike-slip fault. A normal fault occurs where the rock or hanging wall above the fault plane slides down relative to the rock or footwall below the fault plane. Normal faults are usually formed on the divergent boundary, where tectonic plates are separating from each other. Reverse fault. This is the reverse of a normal fault where the rock above the fault plane or the hanging wall slides up relative to the footwall below the fault plane. Reverse fault is formed at the convergent boundary, where the plates meet coming towards each other. Strike-slip fault. This fault is formed when two rocks move side by side instead of up and down. Conversion happens at the limit. Based on the relative motion of tectonic plates, three types of boundaries are formed. Convergent boundary, when two plates from opposite directions come towards each other and collide, they form a convergent boundary. In such boundaries, plates also slide under each other. Folded mountains have been formed on these boundaries. Divergent boundary, when two plates move in opposite directions to each other, their edge is called a divergent boundary. The hot fluid, magma, present in the Earth comes out of the rift between these boundaries and a new solid floor is formed between the two plates. Transform boundary, it is the edge between two plates where the plates slide side by side. Here neither the new crust is formed nor the crust is destroyed, hence they are called transform boundaries. The place from where energy comes out at the time of earthquake is called the center of origin or epicenter. Seismic waves moving from different directions reach the surface of the Earth. Epicenter, the point on the ground which is nearer to the epicenter, is called the epicenter. First of all, the waves are felt at the epicenter only. The epicenter is just above the epicenter, at an angle of 90 degrees. During an earthquake, the energy generated from the epicenter emits waves which we call seismic waves. There are three types of seismic waves which are as follows. 1. Primary or perpendicular waves. These are longitudinal waves, which move at high speed like sound waves. These are also known as P waves. These are very fast moving waves and reach the ground first. It can pass through all three types of substances: solid, liquid, and gas. 2. Secondary or secondary waves. These are transverse waves which move like light. These are also called S waves. Their average velocity is 4 kilometers per second. They can only pass through solid matter. 3. Surface or L waves. These waves are confined to the surface only and can pass through all the three substances: solid, liquid, and gas. They move at a speed of 1.5 to 3 kilometers per second, which is the slowest speed compared to other waves. These waves can travel the longest distance and are highly destructive. How are earthquakes measured? The scale used to measure earthquakes is called the Richter scale. Let's know about the Richter scale. The Richter scale is a mathematical scale used to measure the intensity of an earthquake. This is called the Richter magnitude test scale. On the Richter scale, earthquake waves are measured on a scale ranging from 1 to 9. It is not that the intensity of an earthquake cannot go above 9, but 9 is the last point in the scale because more earthquakes have never occurred till date. The Richter scale was invented in 1935 by scientist Charles Richter and his colleague Gutenberg. Under the Richter scale, the intensity of an earthquake increases 10 times per scale and the energy released during an earthquake increases 32 times per scale. This means that the intensity of an earthquake on the 4 Richter scale will increase 10 times that of the 4 Richter scale on the 5 scale. Apart from the Richter scale, there are two other methods of measuring earthquakes: I, Mercalli scale, and Rossi-Farrell scale. But they are considered less accurate than Richter, so only the Richter scale is used more for measuring earthquakes. How many types of earthquakes are there? The types of earthquakes are divided into three parts. 1. On the basis of depth of earthquake origin. 2. On the basis of the reasons for the origin of the earthquake. 3. Depending on the location of the earthquake. Earthquakes are classified into three parts based on the depth of the earthquake core, which are as follows. Moderate earthquake. In this type of earthquake, the hypocenter is formed at a depth of 50 kilometers from the surface of the Earth. Their magnitude is less, but due to their proximity to the surface, they can be more destructive. Intermediate earthquake. In such earthquakes, the depth of the epicenter is between 50 to 250 kilometers. Their magnitude and intensity are also moderate. Deep earthquakes. As the name suggests, the epicenter of these earthquakes is located at a great depth, 250 to 700 kilometers below the surface. The result and intensity of such earthquakes are both high and they are very destructive. They are also known as underworld earthquakes. On the basis of origin, earthquakes are of two types. 1. Natural earthquake. 2. Man-made earthquake. Earthquakes that occur naturally on their own are called natural earthquakes. These earthquakes can produce destructive waves ranging from simple tremors to earth shaking. These are of two types. 1. Tectonic earthquake. When an earthquake occurs due to the movement between the boundaries of tectonic or tectonic plates, it is called a tectonic earthquake. Most of the earthquakes that occur on the Earth are tectonic earthquakes only. Volcanic earthquakes are generated by the movement of magma beneath the Earth's surface. The movement of magma changes the pressure and increases the pressure on the surrounding rock. In such a situation, the pressure at one point breaks the rock and energy is generated. Man-made earthquake. Earthquakes that are caused by human activities are called man-made earthquakes, which are as follows. 1. Explosion earthquake. When explosions are done during mining testing or nuclear testing, seismic waves are generated, which is called explosion earthquake. 2. Reservoir or dam earthquakes. These earthquakes are felt in those areas where dams are built around. Seismic waves are generated when rock beneath a reservoir moves or breaks. 3. Collapse earthquake. When an excessive amount of mining is done from the ground, the roofs of the underground mines get washed away and earthquakes are felt in the surrounding areas. Such earthquakes are called collapse or collapse earthquakes. On the basis of position, earthquakes are divided into two parts. 1. Terrestrial earthquakes. These types of earthquakes mostly occur in continental regions. Most terrestrial earthquakes occur in the northern part of India. 2. Aquatic earthquakes. These types of earthquakes occur in oceanic regions. Tsunamis occur only because of underwater earthquakes. Advantages and disadvantages of earthquake. Earthquakes are often considered harmful, but do you know that along with losses from earthquakes, there are benefits as well? Let us know about the advantages and disadvantages of earthquakes. Benefits of earthquake. Sometimes, due to earthquakes of high intensity, important minerals come near the surface of the earth. With the help of seismic waves produced by earthquakes, it helps to know about the earth. Rocks become weak due to earthquakes, due to which weathering takes place and soil is formed. This process gives a boost to agriculture. Due to the earthquake, the land sinks down in many places, due to which new water sources and lakes are formed. Due to the earthquake, new topographies of mountains, plateaus, valleys, etc. are formed due to large-scale faults or faults on the Earth's crust. Earthquake damage. Earthquakes cause tremors and rupture of the ground, causing damage to buildings and rigid structures in populated areas. Earthquakes cause landslides and avalanches, causing damage to hilly and mountainous areas. An oceanic earthquake or a landslide caused by an earthquake hitting the sea can cause a tsunami, which can be quite devastating. Due to the earthquake, the land may slide and hit the dam, due to which the dam can be damaged and there can be a danger of flood. Earthquakes also cause human effects such as loss of common property, destruction of roads, bridges and buildings, etc. Along with this, there is a danger of injury and death. Earthquake survival tips. Do not panic in the event of an earthquake and protect yourself by keeping in mind the things given below. If you are at home during an earthquake, sit under a strong table or furniture and cover your head and face with your hands. Stay in the house till the tremors are felt and leave the house only after the tremors stop. If the earthquake occurred at night and you are lying on the bed, do not get up and cover your head with a pillow. If you are buried under the debris after an earthquake, cover your mouth with a handkerchief or cloth. Try banging on something metal or concrete buried under the debris so that rescuers can hear it and reach you. If you don't have any solution, then keep shouting and don't lose heart. What not to do? If you are driving a vehicle, stop it and do not get out. Do not park the vehicle on any bridge or flyover. If you are out of the house, keep distance from buildings and poles and move towards an open space. If you are at home, do not move and take cover under a sturdy piece of furniture or table. Keep distance from glass, windows, doors and walls in the house and go to a corner. After being buried under the debris due to the earthquake, it did not move and did not blow dust. If you are buried under the debris, do not light matches or lighters, as there is a risk of fire due to gas leaks in the house. Do not use the lift during an earthquake even by mistake and avoid going down the stairs. Do not panic at the time of an earthquake and do not spread any kind of rumor. Earthquake FAQ: What is the difference between a seismograph and the Richter scale? Seismographs are used to measure the vibrations of the earth, including seismic waves generated by earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, and other seismic events. Seismologists also use seismic waves recorded by seismographs to map the Earth's interior, locate and measure the origin of earthquakes. At the same time, the Richter scale is used to measure the energy generated during an earthquake. It contains digits from 1 to 9. Q: What is the earthquake center called? The center on the Earth's surface where the earthquake waves first reach is called the epicenter. It is just above the epicenter or epicenter of the earthquake. Q: The most destructive earthquake wave is? L wave, i.e. surface wave, is considered to be the most destructive earthquake wave. Q: On what Richter scale of earthquake, the maximum devastation occurs on the Earth? If the intensity of an earthquake is between 1 to 6 on the Richter scale, then there is not much damage. The same earthquake between 6 to 6.9 Richter scale, there is a danger of cracking the foundation of the buildings and damage to the upper floors. If an earthquake occurs between 7 to 7.9 on the Richter scale, buildings may collapse and pipes may burst underground. An earthquake between 8 and 8.9 can collapse large bridges, including buildings. And if the intensity of the earthquake is 9 or more, then there is a huge devastation. Q. What is the name of the seismometer? Richter scale. Q. Which is the first earthquake wave to reach the surface of the Earth? The P. Waves first reach the surface of the Earth. I hope you must have liked this video of mine. What is an earthquake, why and how an earthquake comes? I have tried my best to provide you with all the information related to the earthquake. If you liked this information or got to learn something new, then please share it. Like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching video.